And Bill will be doing his icebreaker speech tonight, focusing on a major life decision. Bill.
Good evening, everyone. If you don't know me, my name is Bill Wood, and I'm doing my icebreaker speech tonight. And to me, the icebreaker speech is to give the audience a chance to take a glimpse into my life. And since I'm 23 years old, and I spent 20 years in school, I thought, what better way for you guys to get a glimpse into my life than for me to tell you about me choosing my major? This story for me actually started long before I was born. I have a tradition in my family where you can only choose between one of four majors. If you're a girl, you can either be a doctor, a nurse, or a teacher. And if you're a boy, you're an engineer. My great-grandfather was an engineer, my grandfather was an engineer, my dad's an engineer, all my male cousins are engineer, all my male uncles. So as soon as I was born, that little heartbeat, right alongside it, started my engineering heartbeat. Little thump-thump. And I really didn't see a boost in the cadence of that heartbeat until third grade. When I was little, I was dyslexic, so I had a really hard time doing English, spelling, writing. I still am not very good at it. Molly actually proofread one of my papers recently, and I'm still awful at it. But my saving grace in school was math. I loved doing math. And in third grade, you start doing multiplication. And our teacher actually set up like competitions. So me and my classmates, we'd meet up after class, and like we'd work through the worksheets, and we'd like form alliances, like who's gonna be on whose team so we can win the prize. And it really made me realize, like, all right, I love math, and that's a big part of engineering. So that little engineering heartbeat got a little bit faster. So my next time when I feel an increase of that heartbeat wasn't until high school. We're just gonna go over and skip over middle school, because I like to forget the fact that I look like the Pillsbury Doughboy with a Justin Bieber haircut. We're gonna go right into high school, and it was the first chance I got to pick my schedule. So they gave you a choice of either regular chemistry or honors chemistry. And of course, who wants to do more work? So I picked regular chemistry. But there was this super beautiful girl in the honors chemistry class. And I knew she was like having a little bit of trouble doing the work. So during my regular class, I would do all my normal chemistry work, and then I would do all the honors chemistry work. So when I saw her at, like, during lunch, I'd be like, oh yeah, I can tutor on you. It's like no big deal. Because, you know, high school girls love the nerds, so that's my best dad. So I got to spend a lot of time with this girl, and I really fell in love with chemistry because of all the extra studying. So I was like, all right, I'm gonna be a chemical engineer. And that heartbeat got even faster. So I go into my senior year, I'm the captain of my robotics team, and we're in the state championships. And I get to give a little spiel about the robot and go around to other teams and kind of like hobnob and build those alliances so we can try to win it. And we ended up winning the state robotics championship for Florida. So it's like, all right, now I know that I'm smart enough, like I can do engineering, I can compete with these other kids. So that little heartbeat is that finger pitch going super fast. So I go into USF and I declare my major as chemical engineering. And I am loving it at first, but over the next 2 years, that heartbeat gets slower and slower and slower. And I'm into my third year. I come home from a long day of my internship, and I'm doing my integral calculus homework, which is like the least fun thing you can do in the whole entire world. And I was like, wow, I hate this. And then part of me just completely died. So I was sitting there in my room by myself, and I was thinking, what am I gonna do? And a thought popped into my head that my grandmother used to always say. She always used to say, Bill, if engineering doesn't work out for you, you can always be a used car salesman. I was like, thanks a lot, Grandma. You're telling my cousin Seth he's going to be the first man on Mars, and you're telling me that I can sell rust bucket jalopies out of an abandoned lot. But she said, no, Bill, what I mean by that is that you're really good at building relationships with people, and that's something that's really important, and I feel like you really enjoy it. So I thought back to all those experiences where that heartbeat was getting faster. And I realized that it wasn't the math or the science that I really loved. It was those building relationships, hanging out with my friends, hanging out with that girl, doing that hobnob and building those alliances in the robotics. So I knew I something with that was based in relationships. So relationships was really important in the major. So I did all my research, I talked to my advisor, spent hours and hours, and they're like, all right, sociology, that's what you want to do. So I signed up for a bunch of sociology classes, and I went in, and I hated it. I hated the professors, I hated my classmates, I hated the schoolwork. So I was like, great. I spent like 19 years trying to figure out what I wanted to do, and then I still don't know what I am. But luckily, I on a whim, signed up for a basic marketing class. And when I walked into the classroom, on the first thing I saw on the board was marketing equals relationships. And from that point, I was like, all right, this might work out. I might really, really love this. And I go in, and I love it more, and I love it more. I can feel that heartbeat coming back. I can feel it pulsing back in me. I'm starting to get some of my swagger back. I'm starting to feel better. And I get an internship, and I love it even more, and I love it even more. And everything I do in marketing, I was like, all right, this is great. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling like myself again. And actually, last month, I finally graduated with my marketing degree from the University of South Florida, which is like one of the biggest accomplishments in my whole life. So I went from knowing what I was going to do to a huge turning point in my life, and then being able to turn that around and really understand what I loved about me and what I love to do, and that I found that in marketing. And I hope this gave you a little bit of glimpse into who I am, and I hope it helps.